Bangalore is one of the fastest growing city in the world today, and various part of the country people stay here, various variety of people stay here. Here biggest crisis is that drinking water, the best quality drinking water, and Bangalore is the lake city. Today most of the lakes, like out of 1800 lakes, left out is about 240. Out of 240, 80 to 90 lakes are in a little bit better condition. So we are in very pathetic condition, and we thought that, you know, we have abundant water in Bangalore, because 1996 when I seen Bangalore, every house had one well of just 15-20 feet. We used to get a best quality, you know, potable water in the Bangalore, and the city started growing up, right? Buildings started rising, then underground water started growing down. So this is the phenomena, and the major problem for this is our attitude, our negligence towards the, you know, water bodies. That way, in 2016, I decided to take up lake along with the, my job. And since before getting into lake revival journey, I got into, you know, researching of lakes and understanding phenomena of different lakes of Bangalore. And I started visiting about hundreds of lakes across the city, like urban lakes, semi-urban lakes, rural lakes. I tried to understand, being a mechanical guy, I did not know much about ecology and biodiversity. I started learning from Google, I started learning from YouTube videos, and visiting lot of villagers, understanding their decades of phenomena, like meeting people, and all this, you know, research I did about, you know, 1 year's time. Then later on, I come to conclusion that yes, we can do revival of the lake, not a, you know, very, you know, modern way. We should do it an ancient way. See, because these lakes are here thousands of years, they are going to be here thousands of years. I am the guy who come in between and go. So we are just in a transit. So if this lakes has to sustain, this lakes has to be, you know, taking its own course. So then I thought of rejuvenating it an ancient way, ecological way, so that these lakes can take care of their own self, not with a human interference. That way I started working on designing and detailed project reporting. Then I understood that over a period of time, like about 30 acres of lake will be required about 15 to 16 crores, and it will be required about 1 to 2 years time to rejuvenate the lake. Since being a employee, I don't think I can spend so much of time, you know, like I can't take so much of leave. And I don't think I can raise such a huge funds. So then I started working on how to do it in a ecological way and ancient way, with a less time, less cost, so that anybody can, you know, replicate. So that way, with a common sense, I started working on this project. It took about years together time to me. Finally, I decided which lake I should choose. So that way, instead of going in a stranger area, new area, maybe people may not believe and they cannot, you know, like authorities may not support for me. That way, where I was working, and I used to drive every day one lake bed, you know, to reach my office. Then that is a lake of 36 acre, Kalasinelli Lake. Then one day I stopped and I started observing this lake, and I understood that with the villagers, this is a 36 acre lake. And I decided to take up this lake, but so many people told me that first you take 4 acres, then go for 6 acres, then 10 acres, then 20 acres. It's like that, slowly you, then you take up this lake. I thought that no, not like that. Let's take bigger lake only, less cost, less time, ecological way, let us develop this. That way journey is started from 2016. 2017, January onwards, I also spoken with government authorities. I attended one of the seminar called Bring Back the Lake of Bangalore. So in that situation, I understood how government authorities, how other NGOs, how other bigger stakeholders are rejuvenating the lake. So what are the systems they follow? Then what are the, you know, activities they take up? So I learned that also. I learned ancient and other things also. I come to one mean line, that less cost, less time, ecological way. Then I started looking for the funding. since I was working with one of the corporate company last 15 years, Sansera Engineering Limited, my company, I went and discussed with my management that, so can we take up this lake? Can we revive this lake? So they said 1 crore I can give you. Then I started working and I took approval. Then I approached authorities. I got certain approvals from the local authorities. Then after that, I well planned in such a way that instead of I am doing the lake, let me involve villagers and surrounding community. Then I had a friendship with about 5-6 people. I took them. I visited about 450 houses in the particular Kalasinelli village, from kids to middle age to old age. Everybody I approached, I told them that this is the lake I wanted to do, and this is how I wanted to do, and this is what my dream. I don't want money or any support or anything, just I need your backup and you stand with me. And also I told them, this lake I can rejuvenate and go off, end of the day, this lake to sustain, we need your support. That way, April 20th, 2017, government also surveyed and fixed the boundary and given it to us. Then with the 4 earth movers, around 4 trucks, 1 JCB, about 5 labors, we started our journey of rejuvenating the lake. I removed about 4,60,000 cubic meter of mud from this lake. I created 5 islands for the birds, and I created about all around bunds of about 2.5 kilometers, so that all the encroachments and other things, I did not use any fencing or any modern material. This bunds, I put it across the farmers' land so that they will not encroach. Then by June 5th, World Environment Day, I could able to complete entire this lake, rejuvenation. And this has become about from 5 feet water to about 15 to 20 feet water body it has become. And also 5th World Environment Day, with the 1,500 volunteers, with the help of one of the NGO, we planted about 5,600 samplings in just 1.5 hour time. So all these people from city, they came and involved in a plantation drive. They did not plant and just go away from here. They just took a photograph. They, spread in a social media. They started talking to so many their contacts that this lake is rejuvenated in 45 days. And we have planted 1,500 people, like 5,600 saplings in only just 1.5 hour. So that way, this matter spread over a period of time. Lot of like a print media, like a social media, like all electronic media, and they started covering the story of, they mentioned that incredible lake of Kalasinelli, man leads to create a lake in the village. So this story went on, spreading across the thing. And only fear was that there were no rain that year, and the entire lake was dry. I was in high pressure that in July 29th, again, we planted about one of the Miyawaki forest, which is a Japanese cultured method. And there were no water for the 18,000 saplings by July. So August 15th, we flag hoisted in this lake, that first freedom lake of Bangalore, by clearing all the encroachment with the 33, encroachers. We told them that this is the lake it was, and now we have changed it to this. And whatever encroached land, if you leave it to us, so that we can plant fruit trees, and it will be the best ecology and biodiversity. They took a lot of time to realize and understand and come to conclusion. But finally, I could able to convince them and clear about 12 acres of encroachment in this lake. And end of the day, August 15th, I brought 300 kids from various schools, and we have flag hoisted that first freedom lake of Bangalore. Again, it went viral, and people started again appreciating the clearing of encroachment, which authorities are struggling today. And with the police protection law and order, they could not able to clear encroachment because a lot of, huge, problems are they are facing. So that way, September 1st week in the history of Bangalore, with the nature grace, there were no single drop of water. In fact, all the inlets has been dug up kilometers together. We tried to bring in all the catchment water here. So September 11th, about 1,000 or about huge rain entered into the Bangalore, and it is and entire Bangalore started flooding. Authorities, they were giving milk pockets and food pockets to people, but in the lake with the about 500-600 villagers, I was rocking and dancing here because my lake got started filling up the water. 9.5 days to 10 days, I could able to get about 460,000 cubic meter of water in the lake, and it is filled up full of its capacity. So this is how this lake journey is started and ended up with a very happy moment that this lake is full of water, and I had a lot of hopes, and also it is connected spiritually to the surrounding villagers. They started thinking in a spiritual, like if we work on a five elements, they definitely, you know, with a they bless us. That journey started, then a lot of people started approaching me that why don't you take up other lakes. So I was not interested, and because there were, it is not easy to rejuvenate the lake, you know, and a lot of builders mafia by that time, encroachers threatening, and a lot of people they started creating problem and funds problem, like, you know, lot many issues I was facing. That I thought, okay, being consumer of, you know, this planet, whatever air, water, food I have consumed, so I have given back enough, like that I thought. But end of the day, people all around villagers, they started joining me that, you know, we are with you, we will support you, and please continue your journey, because whatever you have done, it is a phenomenal job which, you know, helped surrounding hills, because lot of, you know, wells, bore wells started getting recharged, and people started fresh their agriculture life, then they started growing flowers, fruits and other thing. So end of the day, again corporates also, they started reaching to me that we want to rejuvenate one particular lake like that. I did not had a wider spectrum of rejuvenating lake in a stream wise and other thing, but end of the day I thought this Kalasinelli lake, upper catchment is Vapsandra lake, which is about 9 acres lake, and I thought of, you know, rejuvenating that lake, because this lake I rejuvenated, entire thing is good now, but tomorrow if any dirt water from that lake, it overflows to this lake, then end of the day this lake will also get spoiled. So that way, once I did 45 days, less than 95 lakhs and cleared encroachment, people also started talking, you know, like it is a magical way is done, one lake it is done, it cannot be done everywhere like that. Even Vapsandra lake, 9 acres, with the help of one of the IT corporate, we could able to rejuvenate in a same less than about 50-60 days and less than 1 crore. We have done a best ecological lake there also. So then journey started one by one. Now 2020, I could able to rejuvenate about more than 9 lakes, and 21 lakh cubic meter water holding capacity has been created. I brought with the inspiring people, corporates and all. So today we have got about 180 acres of barren land in the worst place where there was no single drop of water. We have converted into best habitat. See, it has become now natural habitat. Like we have developed in such a way that aquatic life and flora and fauna all around. And we have about 115 species of like fruits, medicinal plants and flowering plants we have planted. We have about 66 variety of birds roaming around our lakes. We have from 1/2 inch to 3 feet, 15 kg fishes available in our lakes. And all the villagers also, we have put a lot of wetlands like grassland, traditional forest, as well as Miyawaki forest we have created in all the lakes. So entire, you know, like this success story is started creating ripple effects in myself and others also. So whole idea now is like by 2025, I started dreaming of rejuvenating 45 lakes in Bangalore. And I started working with a lake revivers collective, Save India, one lake at a time with this concept. 21 cities will going to be zero water by 2020. We started also creating awareness and less cost, ecological way, how we can revive the lake. This journey started. Now, I also started, you know, training programs like workshops, like a lake rejuvenation and a law behind lakes, science behind lakes, like ecological way, how we can restore the lake and less cost, less time. What are the tools we can apply? We started, you know, like workshops, training programs, lot many things, so that not only I am rejuvenating the lake. See, like in Karnataka itself, we have about 36,000 change lakes which are registered lakes. And across the country, if you take in close together lakes are there, one lake, 10 lake cannot bring huge change, you know, and one man like me cannot change so many lakes. So we started inspiring youth, middle-aged, corporates, NGOs, as well as authorities that, you know, we should rejuvenate the lake in an ecological way so that we can have a surplus water in my nation. So that way, So this journey continues, not only for the country like India, state like Karnataka, like city like Bangalore, across the planet. We should work on, you know, such a ecological way, say that, you know, we can have a surplus water in the planet. So now other lot of countries, I'm in touch with lot of many peoples, and they also, we exchange knowledge each other. Like, you know, like each lake is different phenomena based on the soil condition, weather pattern, and the kind of flora fauna, and the way city developed or the way agriculture developed. So like every lake is challenging, every area is very complicated. Even I am upgrading myself, I am also sharing my experience with people. So this is how lake journey started. And end of the day, what I am trying to tell is our environment and economy should go hand in hand. It should not be imbalanced. See, whatever economy we see, whatever GDP we see, it is a reflection of environment in the mirror. So if it is imbalanced, same ugly thing will transfer here. So today, if you see this phenomenon of across the planet, we started destroying forest, water bodies, ecology and biodiversity. End of the day, because of our more greed and other thing, and we spoiled everything. And we lived responsibly. One small micron level, less than micron level, one coronavirus shaked the entire planet. They put us, you know, into home. And it created like a entire 730 crore people are become patients today. So let's not give opportunity to, you know, restore its own by the environment. We should live responsibly. We should also, like 84 crore species people, out of that humans also, we should live coexistence, and we should live in a harmony. And if we take care of environment, that is a better way than leaving it in an environment hand to, or nature hands to restore it back. So I am a lake conservationist, I become now. From a corporate life, I shifted to completely like a environmentalist as a lake conservationist. How about you? So are you joining with me? Are you, you know, are you starting your own journey? Not only lake restoration, anything we should do, we should not leave here and just go off like a, you know, stranger. We should leave something for our next generation and go. That is the whole idea. My idea is I'm working with water and forest and wildlife. How about you? Please support, please join the journey. Let's all, you know, create a best, you know, place to live in. Thank you.